This here is another viewer's small but broken gaming PC, and we're gonna try in this video to fix it. Now I'm gonna read the email I got from the owner regarding the issues this system is exhibiting. He says, "Hey Greg, I came into my office and saw that there was a black screen. I thought maybe it had just gone to sleep, but it wouldn't wake, and when I tried to turn it off using the front panel connector, it didn't work and the light stayed on. This is my first build, so I did everything I could to diagnose the issue, but no luck." He actually took it to Geek Squad, and Geek Squad apparently just, they told him it was a motherboard and they told him he should RMA it. So he did that, but still the same issue persists. So maybe this system was misdiagnosed by Geek Squad, or maybe the RMA request he sent and whatever was sent back to him was still defective. So who really knows? He says it won't boot, won't post, or anything. So this sounds like the perfect candidate for the Fix or Flop playlist, and that's why it's here. Hopefully we can fix it for him. Stay with me. To get rid of that annoying activation watermark, hop on over to VIP SCD Key and purchase a Windows 10 Pro OEM key for fractions of the price of retail. Just use a secure payment method like PayPal, receive your key in seconds, and activate your OS here. Bye-bye, watermark. And be sure to use our new offer code SKGS for a sweet discount. Now, for those who are new to the Fix or Flop playlist, the premise here is simple. We reach out to folks in and around the Orlando, Florida area and ask them if they have broken systems in need of a proper fixing. The caveats are we don't charge them anything so long as they're okay with us taking on their system for a few days and as long as they're okay with us filming the process. I can monetize these videos. This is where I make my money, and I don't offload any of that to the viewers who are already gracious enough to loan us their systems for a few days. So let's kick things off with system specifications. He's got an NZXT H1, obviously. I'll check to see if he's got the nylon screw replacements for the riser cable. He's got a B450i Aorus Pro motherboard, a Ryzen 5 3600X, Radeon 8 gig, what is this, a 570 Armor 8 gig graphics card, Corsair Vengeance LPX, he's got two 16 gig DIMMs, he's got a Samsung 970 Evo SSD, half a terabyte, and he's got a 1 terabyte WD Blue SSD and a 2 terabyte WD Blue SSD for work and games and things. So essentially this here is his work from home system, and that's why he's been so desperate to get this up and running, because this is how he makes a living, so that's why I'm going to do everything I can to get this working for him. That, and he already took the time to drive out to meet me, so we'll see if we can hook him up. Now, the first thing we do at the beginning of every troubleshooting process is attempt to power the system on. We need to replicate the issue described by the owner in order to make sure that what we're seeing lines up with what he or she was seeing. If not, then it's possible something else might have been damaged in transport, and that's an entirely new can of worms that you might not want to deal with as a business owner. In my case, usually I can replace things either way, so it's not really too big a deal. But nonetheless, we're going to power it on and see if it actually powers on. Apparently it doesn't. So with everything hooked up, I've got HDMI connected to our portable monitor here. I think we are ready to power on. Let's try the power button. That didn't do anything. Let me see if our power supply is even on. Ah, this should, it should be on. There we go. So let's try this again with the power supply actually switched on. Okay, system is on. Fan spinning, I can feel fluid in the AIO churning. So the pump is okay, but I'm not getting a picture out. I wonder if part of the problem he was having was the fact that the power supply wasn't even turned on. It sounds like it was working at some point. Maybe when he had it serviced, he just kept it off. But yeah, I mean, we're not getting a picture out. I really hope it's not his graphics card. I mean, relatively speaking, RX 570s and 470s are fairly cheap, but still, in today's market, you're going to be overpaying with respect to what you would have paid a couple years ago to replace this card, even secondhand on eBay or elsewhere. So it's not ideal, but I've got a feeling that's what, I don't know why, but I just have a feeling that it's going to be his graphics card. I kind of want to tackle that first. So let's get these side panels off. Kind of a task in the H1, because you're gonna take the front and back panels off first before you can slide two side panels off. But there we go. just gonna check connections while I'm here. Obviously, we're gonna have to run through this stuff anyway if this ends up not being a graphics card problem. He does have his card powered with supplemental PCIe power, and the riser cable looks to be intact. He doesn't have nylon screws installed. I don't know if this is the new riser cable or not. I don't recall what it looks like, if it looked any different. But I'll be sure to ask him about this, and if he hasn't already updated it, he should. So we're gonna disconnect his card and replace it, one moment, with my trusty GT710. Wow, this looks so cringe in this. Oh my gosh, like this whole area here is dedicated to a discrete card, and we've got just a super small compact GT710. This poor thing, it's a trooper, even though it's really not all that powerful, really, at all. So now we can try again for a picture. I've got the power supply switched on, and everything is connected. All right, here we go. I've said this before in this playlist, but I'm kind of hoping that it's not his graphics card. It's a bit easier for me to replace other components. The graphics card is the one thing that even I struggle to get a hold of, any kind of card for that matter. It's just, I'd probably end up having to buy a replacement card myself just to get a hold of something, because it's difficult to get anyone to send anything. I'm not seeing a picture out though, which means it's probably not his graphics card, which means this is going to involve much more deconstruction than I was originally anticipating. Let's get into the heart of this thing. I think we're gonna be spending the bulk of our time with this motherboard, since this is the thing that Geek Squad suspected was to blame for the no post issue, the no picture out. But what I wanna do next is verify the integrity of connections. We can actually do that real quick here. So 24 pin, front panel, 8 pin APS, fan connections, those all look good. HD audio, SATA. So I don't see user error being a possibility here. Connections on the power supply side, this is modular. Those all look fine. And again, the pump is working, so it's not like the CPU is instantly overheating or anything like that. This is, again, a Ryzen 5 CPU B450i motherboard. So what I'm going to do now is strip this down to just motherboard, CPU, cooler, RAM, and power supply. No other connections, just to rule out that something was miswired that I'm not seeing here. Also gonna swap and reseat RAM here just to rule out another variable during this process. There we go. Are we gonna get anything? That is the question. With everything disconnected, I have to jump these pins manually. Should probably connect something, that way I can tell that it's on. Okay, so the system is on. Whoa! Had to be RAM. That's what I'm thinking, it has to be RAM. Because, I mean, all we did was unplug everything else, but I didn't really expect that to do anything because everything was connected the way that it should have been. Wow. There's his system. His system works fine. Oh, this fan's getting hot. It's because the pump is not connected. All right, we're turning it back off. So we're going to retrace our steps now to narrow down what exactly it was. I am going to reconnect his two memory modules first and attempt to power the system on. If it works, then what I'll do is start connecting components one by one. So we'll connect his SSDs, we'll connect the HD audio. I don't expect, again, that any of this is really to blame for the system not posting. It seems a bit odd. I think it came down to memory. It's likely that one of those was not seated properly. When I removed them, they felt fine. They felt like they were in there where they should have been, but you just never know. So let's go backwards. So we'll reconnect his modules here. And there we are, so we're still getting a post. Interesting, so this might have been some sort of wiring issue. I suspect that it might have been maybe a dead memory channel like we had in the previous episode of this playlist, but not the case. Both memory sticks work just fine.
A few moments later.
Huh, everything works fine. I reconnected everything, we're still getting a post. It's in the recovery window because I've had to reset this thing so many times, but it's all working. It must have just been an improperly seated memory module. That's all I can think of. It wasn't the front panel connector, because that's a unified connector in the NZXT case. So it just plugs in one way, it's keyed. Same with the HD audio connector, and then his two SATA data cables. That was it. I mean, we had already tried plugging in the fan and the pump. That didn't affect anything. So, I don't know. This one's a bit strange. I think it was just memory. I mean, if you've been building systems for a while, you probably know that memory can be a bit stubborn at times. If only a couple of pins are not making contact with the module in the slot, then you could end up with something like this here, where you got a black screen, but with the system technically on and fans technically spinning.
If I recall correctly, these LEDs under the motherboard weren't even on before when we weren't getting a post, but now you can see, I didn't know this board had these, but they are lit up now. So what I'm gonna try to do, and I don't recommend you do this, but I'm gonna do it because I can replace things if something happens to break. I'm gonna intentionally, improperly seat one of these modules, just to see if we can replicate the no post issue. I don't know if you can tell, but I've got this front module, the one closer to the socket, raised slightly higher than the one further away from it. Both locking mechanisms are up, technically. This one's not all the way up. You can see it's slightly pulled back. But to the untrained eye, this would look properly seated, right? So now let's try to power the system on.
And would you look at that? Powered on, the fan spins, and we don't have a post. And we also don't have the LEDs lit up under the motherboard. So I'm very, very confident now that it was just an improperly seated memory module. Which you'd think, you know, come on, that seems like an obvious issue. Like anybody would notice that. But again, I just showed you, it looks like both are seated. From this angle here, it looks like the modules are where they should be. There's just a tiny little bit of raising on one side of one DIMM, and that's all it takes to get this symptom here, where it seems like the system should be working. And you'd think, oh, well, that's gotta be the graphics card then, which is what I thought at first. I didn't think to check memory first. I cleared the CMOS. I did that much earlier in the video. I didn't mention it, but I always check that right away because that's a very quick fix. And still nothing. So that's what I think it was. Improperly seated memory. And again, if you've been building PCs for a while, you know how annoying this one can be. It is actually a very frequent issue that folks run into. And in one continuous shot here, I'm gonna power the system back off. Okay, I'm gonna drain power. And all I'm gonna do is push this module further into the slot, okay? Once we do that, that's all it takes. We can power the system back on. And this time we should get a post. I'm gonna look pretty stupid if we don't. Okay, there we go. Yeah, so you get the orange lights under the board now, and should be getting a picture on screen. There we go. So that's all it took, and that's again why I think it was just a memory seeding problem.
The last thing to do then is reconnect his graphics card, and if our expectations are correct here, our assumptions about this build, then connecting this back shouldn't change anything about his system. Since the card seemed fine, let's reconnect PCIe power, and we'll screw this down in a second. I just wanna make sure that it posts first. So let's reconnect the HDMI cable.
And look at there, no problems at all. So his system is actually ready to go. This ended faster than I thought it would.
Well, this could have ended up being much worse than it was. And it all came down to a simple DDR4 seating issue. At least that's what I suspect based on the test we replicated here. It could have been something much worse, and I was prepared to take the entire motherboard out. And in a case like the NZXT-H1, that can be a bit difficult, a bit time-consuming, because you have an AIO in the way, and it's just all kind of crammed in there. I almost went that far, but I checked the connections, and I checked DDR4 before doing that, because I wanted to rule out those simpler possibilities. Now, you could argue, well, Greg, why'd you take the graphics card out? That took a little bit more time than just checking DDR4. Yeah, that's true. I just went off of a hunch. I wanted to see if I could guess it right out of the gate correctly. But no, it was DDR4. That simple. This is why I recommend running through the simple checks up front, even if you suspect that they are not to blame. Clear the CMOS, check connections, check DDR4, DDR3 seating, whatever's coming up next, DDR5. Check those things because they take seconds, and it's good to have that peace of mind when you start diving deeper into a broken rig, really. I'm sure the owner is going to be thrilled to hear that his system is back to working order and that it really didn't require much of anything at all. We didn't have to replace any components. All of his data is still intact. And again, I just had to spend a few seconds reseating memory. In fact, if I was a boutique PC builder, maybe ran a PC repair shop, I personally, unless I couldn't justify it financially, would be upfront and honest about how short a time it took to troubleshoot and to fix the issue, and I wouldn't charge him anything. I would just say, hey, you know, it didn't take very long, and you know, I don't feel right charging anything for it because it took minutes out of my day, not hours. And I'd be willing to bet that that would pay off dividends in the long run, because he'd probably go and tell his friends, hey, this guy, he could have charged me anything, could have said it took him hours, could have replaced things. But he was honest, and he didn't charge me anything at all. So if you have any issues with your systems, bring them to this guy, right? That's how you make a positive impact. That's how you build a positive reputation in this industry. So if you're in that position, maybe consider doing that. But hey, the system works, and at the end of the day, that's all I'm really concerned with. I know this was a shorter video, a bit unorthodox for this playlist, but that's a testament to the fact that this is random, right? I never know what's going to come in through the door. I have my suspicions as to what could be at fault, but it's a box of chocolates. It's all random, and these are all puzzles for me. And I hope that you guys are having as much fun as I am troubleshooting these. It's definitely interesting, some of the issues that we've run into so far, and I appreciate your support. Your feedback has been just immense. It has been awesome and so motivating. I hope to continue these kinds of videos in the future. So if you live in the Orlando, Florida area and you have an issue with your system and it seems like it's a hardware issue, be sure to either email me or tweet me. Info is in the video description. Leave a comment, leave a like. If you aren't subscribed, I'll give you a few seconds to fix that. Good? Cool. I appreciate that. And yeah, stay tuned for the next one. My name is Greg. Thanks for learning with me.